Two things need to be talked about tonight. The fact that for a very long time, people from the establishment in cricket in India, people close to the establishment, those in the establishment, those seeking favors from the establishment, those who want to be on the right side of the establishment, and all the sycophants and everyone else kept all of them. All of them were in total denial mode that there is anything wrong with Indian cricket. The same people today, their jaws are dropping at the possibility of the IPL being called off. That's issue number one tonight. And the second issue, and I know we like Kishore Bimani, welcome. I hope you today will not pull your punches. Sadbing Jung from Bengaluru, welcome. Bimal Soni, he used to be batting for Srinivasan till recently. I don't know if he will tonight. B. Mohan says players should not suffer. He speaks openly, former Ranji player. And Atul Vasan, my favorite punching bag on these issues on the News Hour tonight, former Indian cricketer. Thank you very much, all of you, for joining me. You know, Kishore Bimani, we like to create halos around people and turn cricketers into gods and demigods and everything else. So even if now, after Sachin Tendulkar, people think Mahendra Singh Dhoni is the next god, right? A reigning god of Indian cricket. The question is this. What was Mahendra Singh Dhoni doing? He was building a case for a man who was most compromised and compromising cricket. Right? For a tainted man misusing his position in Chennai Super Kings, went before the Mudgal committee and said, oh, he's just an enthusiast. Why should we not believe that Mr. Mahendra Singh Dhoni was being selective with the truth? I'm being polite here. I mean, he should step down as the cricket captain, well, shouldn't he? Let him step down on ethical grounds now.
He was being... You see... He was being very economical with the truth. That's one way of putting it. The fact is, this whole cozy club or not that we've been talking about, which comprises Mr. Srinivasan, the president, his son-in-law, the captain of the team. There are two or three other people who work for India Cement. Mr. Srinivasan runs the board. Mr. Srinivasan runs CSK. Mr. Srinivasan wants to be ICC chief. And all this, today, what it does is it conceals all the real purpose of cricket. And Dhoni, with supreme arrogance.
Absolute.
Says, no, Gurunath was nobody. He's not an owner.
Oh, yes.
Now, this is the problem. That how can today the Indian captain have no respect for law, no respect for justice, no respect for...
Because this is the kind of refinements of cricket. This is the kind of cocky arrogance that he was allowed to get away with. I mean, he calls him an enthusiast. Tell me, Atul Vasan, would an enthusiast attend team meetings? Dhoni didn't know. Would he attend practice sessions? Dhoni didn't know. He attends an IPL owner's workshop. Mahendra Singh Dhoni doesn't know. He travels with the team. Mahendra Singh Dhoni has his eyes closed. He sits at an auction table. Atul Vasan, Mahendra Singh doesn't know. He manages the team. Dhoni doesn't know. And all this while, everybody, including you, Atul, including you, never asked this question. Then why is Dhoni being selective with the truth? Why didn't you ask the question, Atul? Why didn't you ask the question?
Okay. Before you jump on me, you know, I'm in total agreement with you that, you know, it was a very juvenile and amateur attempt at whatever transpired. And, you know, I'll tell you why it happens. It's happened. It's wrong. I'm not condoning or, you know, agreeing to the fact that, it, you know, but the point is that the guy is the Indian captain. He's not superhuman. He actually
superhuman.
Has to.
So you're allowed to lie if you're the Indian captain.
The board has been going. You
can lie if you're the Indian captain.
No, I'm telling you. No, super. No, a lie. Okay. You know, again, if he, no, I'm just saying, because, you know, if hindsight is such a lovely thing, if you would have known that 2 months later is going to blow up in everybody's face.
Prompt
committee being formed and given a clean chit after a week, you know, so
what's
wrong?
You're going before a Supreme Court monitored committee.
Why is happening? Because the board structure is such that everybody has to fall in line.
What do you mean fall in line?
I'm just saying that why?
What do you mean fall in line? Supreme Court appointed committee. One minute. Let's be clear.
This is how the board operates. Are you with the board or against the board? If you stick your neck out, I've done it. Pension gets stopped. Nobody answers me. I don't get any jobs. You know, if anybody
here's a wonderful proposition.
Let's get one thing right.
Okay, Saad, go ahead.
Let's get one thing right. It's not that we didn't say it. For heaven's sake, on this channel, we have said exactly that there can be no fix without a captain. And it's not that Dhoni has not been warned. It's not that Dhoni didn't know what the hell he was doing.
Absolutely.
Come on, yeah. He has no business to hide behind a conflict of interest to please the head of BCCI because he is also the president of the company he works for. If that's not conflict of interest coming into play, then what is? So Atul, let's you know, other cricket captains of this country have been questioned. They've come out of it.
I mean, we're saying the same thing in a different way. You're right.
I understand.
I'm telling you, Saad Ben.
Where is the different way, Atul?
Listen to me. You know, I mean, you are being part of the system.
There's
no difference. There's a different way. You know,
it's not just us. It is the entire integrity of cricket. Yeah.
Yeah. I've got your point.
And you'll be sitting here and saying, you know, there's a softer way.
Oh my God, where have you been?
I'm sorry, there are only two gentlemen.
I'm saying the system is wrong.
I'm not part of the system. I am not part of the system. And I'll tell you something, there are only two gentlemen today in the whole world of cricket.
Anybody who has played for the ball.
No, one sec. Gentlemen, my question is, look at, no, Bimal Soni. For example, Bimal Soni. Now, I have nothing personally against him, but he's a nice man. He speaks well. He's deputy president of the Rajasthan Cricket Association, and Mr. Soni has been one of the staunchest defendants of Mr. Srinivas. Right. Now, Mr. Soni, you have been. You may not be now. You know, seasons change and loyalties change.
I have only one thing. No loyalty change. What I have to say is, I am very clear. Mr. Dhoni has done a mistake by saying what he has said in front of the Mudgal committee. But I want to question him once again, asking him that if he has done this perjury, was it under pressure? Was it a fault of his own? Does he take that fault as if he has said lies? Or was he under pressure to say those things? Because under the circumstances in which the board is being run today, Mr. Srinivasan rules the day. Not many people can go against him. Not many people can speak against him. And this is the same Dhoni who was removed by chairman of the selection committee, who wanted him to be changed. And Dhoni was not changed, but the chairman selection committee was changed.
Yes.
So what I am saying, Arnab, that he consciously gave the statement in favor of Mariappan, was it under pressure? Was it by his goodwill?
And you?
One minute. Do you know what it amounts to? Do you know what saying something wrong?
I said perjury. I said the word perjury. How many people in BCCI? How many people today are speaking against? How many people came up when the action was to be taken?
Did you come up?
When Mr. Srinivasan joined
back? Did you come up? Let me ask you directly. Did you come up?
You are under a wrong impression. No, I am not a member of the BCCI.
No, 1 minute.
I've been saying, I don't represent Rajasthan.
The question is this. One second. I'm getting B. Mohan. We are on an interesting point. Now the question goes out. Forget the sentimentality, okay? We are playing a tournament in Dhaka. I know many people will weep. Oh my God. They will say, you know, the morale of the team will be affected if you do something to Dhoni. Please don't touch Dhoni. Mahi must not be touched. But I say today, what about the morale of this country? The morale of this country. The morale of this country and cricket lovers will go down if tomorrow you have a captain who is under question for being selective with the facts, who may or may not have known that Gurunath Mayappan was party to sensitive information about team strategy, but went before a Supreme Court committee and said he's just a cricket enthusiast. Why should Mahendra Singh Dhoni not be called to account? He should be asked, either you step down from India Cements, your vice president of India Cements, Mr. Mohan, what a ridiculous situation. Vice president of India Cements, captain of the Indian cricket team, you've got everything sorted for you. You make up facts when you go before the Supreme Court monitored committee and nobody touches you. You hope you'll put out a decent performance tomorrow and everything will be forgotten. Mr. Mohan, what should be done to Mr.
Dhoni? As a captain of as a captain of Indian team, he's got a lot of responsibility to perform well. And there are so many people who try to be in touch with him. So whatever he said, so it might be in his own terms, he might have told that he's enthusiastic. No. But what I'm saying is, cricket is not everything. He has to take up a job. So he's been made as the vice president for Indian Seamen. What's wrong?
No, what do you mean?
Everything is not cricket. So he has to take a job. So that's also
important.
You
are saying he needs...
I'm not defending
You are saying that Mahendra Singh Dhoni...
Dhoni does not need a job.
You are saying Mahendra Singh Dhoni...
Dhoni does not need a job.
No, this is brilliant. One second. Atul Vasan, here's Mr. Mohan, who says Mahendra Singh Dhoni needs a 75,000 or 50,000 rupee job at India Cements to sustain himself.
Insult our intelligence, you know. Are you right? Exactly. Even if it's 50 lakhs.
Doing a job also gives a lot of satisfaction. Everything is not cricket. You see how many test players are all the state bank officers.
Mr. Mohan, what job does... One minute. I want to ask you. The designation that Mahendra Singh Dhoni...
It is not the money, it is the name.
Somebody is trying to defend...
Name is important.
If somebody is trying to defend that Dhoni actually believes that
who used the word enthusiast first?
Insulting our intelligence.
No, the word enthusiast was used
by... Did Srinivasan use it and Mahendra Dhoni follow up?
Srinivasan used it, Mahendra Dhoni followed up.
Who used the word enthusiast?
Srinivasan said it, Mahendra Singh Dhoni was repeating it like a parrot.
Fell in line with whatever he was told.
So how come? How is that possible? Yeah. That 50,000 rupees a month is not going to make that possible,
simple.
My friend.
So the question is Mahendra Singh Dhoni...
It is possible because of the whole conflict of interest.
Even 50 lakh rupees is nothing for, you know,
The question is Mahendra Singh Dhoni Srinivasan's caged parrot? And if Mahendra Singh Dhoni is Srinivasan's caged parrot, then we want to know if he is. Otherwise, is he just parroting Srinivasan's words? And how inethical is that?
Because everybody is.
Who bears
Why
the
consequence? Why single out one person?
No, who bears the consequence?
No, I'm sorry. No, here.
Arnab, I would like to come in between.
Yes.
Arnab.
Yes, Mr.
Arnab, I would like to speak on this. In the circumstances, even today, so many questions have been asked to ex-cricketers who have retired. But have they commented? I am seeing so many channels today. Nobody is trying to take on Srinivasan's mistakes.
Absolutely. I am saying it on record today. Mr. Rahul Dravid, what happened to you? When you talk big talks, you know, when you go there, you deliver big speeches at the Bradman lecture. Here is your chance, Mr. Rahul Dravid. Come out and question Dhoni and come out and question Srinivasan. What do you say, Kishore Bhimani? Where is Sachin Tendulkar, the god of cricket? Where is Sourav Ganguly?
For so many months we have been saying, Arnab, that the great players, the great cricket personalities are very so loudly silent.
Absolutely.
Today, a handful of people have spoken up. Today you are talking about the morale of the team in Dhaka. What about the morals of the country?
Absolutely.
Are we to say that our captain can do what he likes because he needs that job in India Cement? I mean, I'm embarrassed with 41 years in cricket to see an Indian captain who arrogantly says that Gurunath Maipan is nothing to do with the team. He doesn't own the team. He's just one of the people who hangs around. I mean, that is terrible.
Knowing that
you are in front of Justice Mudgal, knowing that you are committing perjury, knowing that you are misleading the country, those who love cricket, and you can actually have defendants who will tell you that the poor man needs a job. I'll give him a job.
You think he'll buy that? Tell me, Kishore Bhimani, frankly, tell me, do you think Mahendra Singh Dhoni did not know Gurunath Maiappan's real role?
If he did not know Gurunath Maiappan's real role, I would give up talking on TV. I'd go and do penance. I'd forget all about cricket. If Mahendra Singh Dhoni is one of the most intelligent captains I have met, efficient cricketers, and he knows everything that goes on. Now, somebody talked about pressure, Arnab. I mean, here is a man who handles pressure better than any cricketer in the world. He can't handle the pressure of his boss. He can't handle the pressure of the Board of Control president. Handle the pressure of being in that situation.
I said Dhoni is as responsible, therefore... Saad, Dhoni is as responsible as Srinivasan. In all of this, because Dhoni
For heaven's sake, they're both.
Yeah.
See, their arrogance, so, their Dhoni arrogance, their the joint arrogance has become the agony of...
By India.
No, what does this, what does this success as a captain have to do with it?
I want to talk about that, Jara. Can I please say that the joint arrogance has become the agony of a monopoly, of a draconian monopoly. Together, they have completely ruined the whole situation that cricket stood on. Because you have cricket captain of India, and you have the cricket boss who's gone on to become the ICC boss.
And where so, is, what about...
If you look at the Mudgal, one more thing. In the Mudgal report, if you read, and these are open documents, this is not the closed seal, which was sent to me by our office. I'm not taking the names because they're not being cleared by legal, but the names are bigger than Mr. Dhoni. The bookies are discussing names bigger than Mr. Dhoni as far as cricket. They have the guts to go ahead and take these names and say, isko fix kar sakte hain kya, isko fix karte hain. Dhoni, he should have known that there is fixing and run for his life and stayed far away, na? Why did he become part of it, yeah? But why did he become part of that whole group?
Mr. Atul Vasan, Mr. Mohan says everybody needs to earn a living. Fine, everybody needs to earn a living, Atul. But when MS Dhoni is testifying before the Mudgal committee, I have three questions. Is he testifying as captain of India? Or is he testifying as captain of Chennai Super Kings? Or is he testifying as the vice president marketing of India Cements? I don't know. Do you, Atul?
I think, well said. I tell you what, you know, I mean, if you are trying to defend it, no, I don't, you know, it's I see insulting our intelligence if we believe that actually he felt that Mayappan was an enthusiast, you know, we all know what happened and why it happened. I can tell you the reason, you know, because the system has been working like this and now it's come to something. Now they realize, oh my God, you know. In hindsight, he must be ruining the fact that why he did that, you know, because nobody knew that the Supreme Court is going to jump in and tell and use words like nauseating to finally define what cricket's administration in the country is, you know. So eventually, I hope that, you know, now people realize it's such a grave importance and,
the way it is structured, unless we do something about the
constitution of the board, nothing's going to happen, please.
If
a cricketer can be appointed by the Supreme Court, unless he runs around for proxies, unless he actually, you know, have ground soldiers in the committees and the state associations, nothing's going to happen.
What comes out of this, you know, Saad and Bimal, I'd put this to you. What comes out of this is we've always had this feeling administrators are bad and players are good. Right? Cricket bosses are bad and cricketers are essentially angelic human beings who are sometimes sucked into the nefarious politics of their bosses. Now tell me, MS Dhoni, an angelic human being, poor man knows nothing about politics. Srinivasan is using him. So how is it that MS Dhoni repeats exactly what Srinivasan told reporters during his press conference on May 26th following the arrest of Guru Nath Mayappan? He has exactly same words, right? Now, today, every cricketer is silent. Saad, Sachin Tendulkar has not said one word. I want to know where Sachin Tendulkar is tonight. Where is Rahul Gandhi tonight? Where is Sachin Saurav Tendulkar, Ganguly? Anil Kumble looking so nervous? Saad, does it bust this myth that players are good and bosses are bad? Because eventually all the players and bosses are mixed up in this together. I'm not taking other names. You know who I'm talking about.
Players have proven time and time again that they are worse than the administrators. I mean, I used to imagine that could be impossible to do that. But now, since the 1990s, since the match-fixing era, and since nothing has happened, the players have only taken for granted that it's permissible, and they've gone one step after another, they just carried on going. There was a player, there were 82 tapes that were of him, which were being sold on Janpath in the 90s, which was part of Parliament record, I think. Players have no right today, and therefore they are not in a position to, because they've been so badly compromised at every step, whether it's by money, whether it's by legitimate money or illegitimate money, I don't know. But they've been completely compromised where, to the extent now, they don't even have a voice where they're saying that it's sub judice, so we don't have a voice.
They're scared.
Arey Baba, cricket is suffering, cricket is getting hammered. We are dying over here. We want to know what the hell is going on and what do you people think?
Because
the judge has to decide. Arey, of course he has to decide.
What a shame. What a shame. Bimal Soni. MS Dhoni is showing a lot of arrogance right now. He's not even resigned from India Cements. leave alone step aside as the captain, if Srinivasan has to step aside till the inquiry is on, what about the captain who repeated the exact same words like Srinivasan's parrot? He gets away with it. Should...
Arnav, that's what I'm trying to say. That what Atul Vasan has said, what he has said is that Dhoni didn't realize that things would come to this level. What he was speaking was like a parrot of the boss. Whatever Thank boss you. Had spoken, he spoke to the Mudgal committee.
Yes.
And he was under pressure.
Srinivasan would say
I'm
him.
Agreeing again that it is perjurious. And now we should ask him again that look, you were speaking under pressure or you feel what you said is right.
No,
and if he says, no, I was speaking under pressure, give him that benefit. Because listen, even
no, why,
if the
focus, why give him benefit? Give him benefit. Kishore Bimani, give him benefit. Let him get away if he says, I was speaking under pressure.
I'm not saying get away.
No, one
let him ask pardon for the mistake. Let him ask pardon for the mistake.
Is any defense anybody makes? Anybody can commit a crime and says, I did it under pressure?
What?
I mean, I am hearing this kind of thing for the first time. Pressure or no pressure?
On this issue,
if you can take on the pressure of fast bowlers, you take on the pressure of your boss.
Absolutely.
Of course he should resign his captain.
No, but who is he protecting? Arnab, one second. Who is he protecting? Arnab, is he protecting Guru Nath or is he, my God, for heaven's sake, I don't think he's protecting himself. Why would he lie? Is he lying to protect himself?
He's protecting his interests.
Like say that.
He's protecting his interests.
He's protecting his interests. Yes, I agree with you.
Yes, please. Mr. Mohan, quickly.
I like to say that Dhoni is the most successful captain for India.
No,
and when they play the IPL franchise, it's a different tournament.
No, please.
And I agree with Atul that... state association, they don't have the representation of players. If they have the representation of the players, they can definitely fight for some good cause.
No,
and there's voting rights or anything.
We're going to take a break and come back for five more minutes of this debate because one of our panelists says
try to damage the image
I'm putting this question to you. I'll take a couple of calls today also. I'll take a break, come back in 5 minutes, and I'm going to open up to calls because getting a lot of feedback into our newsroom. Should Dhoni step aside or should we just forgive him and say he came under pressure? I'm back in a couple of minutes. Well, one question is, of course, of the moral accountability of Mahendra Singh Dhoni. I'm going to take some questions on that because he's the very serious charge that he knew about Gurunath Maiyappan and held back the truth, which is a logical thing to say. Harish Salve raises in the Supreme Court and now the pressure is as much on Dhoni as it is on Srinivasan. We'll take a first caller and it's Sanjay from Bangalore. Sanjay, good evening. Arnab here. You have a question?
Arnab,
hi.
Arnab, lovely to speak to you again.
Good talking Sanjay, to you. Yes, Sanjay.
Hi, Saad. I'm really asked, my question is basically, why should these three great men of cricket, Srinivasan, Dhoni and Guru Nath, not be asked to lead, whether it's the BCCI or the Indian team or the IPL? I am, in the true sense, a cricket enthusiast, and that's in inverted commas. And it pains me to see what is going on. Is Srinivasan such a horror that no one dares stand up to him? Where are Ravi Shastri, Anil Kumble, Kapil Dev,
Sachin Tendulkar?
Any of them?
You forgot Sachin Tendulkar. Where is Sachin Tendulkar?
Precisely. And in fact, to a large extent, Sunil Gavaskar himself, who is being considered by the Supreme Court to take over as BCCI chief.
Absolutely.
Sunil Gavaskar is another person who will never antagonize the BCCI.
Absolutely. On the right side always. Completely politically correct. The diplomat of cricket. Sanjay, good points. Good points. You know, that question goes therefore to Bimal Soni. Bimal Soni, you've been part of the establishment, you know. Everyone comes together, don't they? To cover up all the taint of cricket. There was an August 2011 report on anti-corruption measures commissioned by the ICC, which warned the IPL is prone to match fixing. All of you, and I say all of you, including you, all cricket administrators sat down and put a cover over it. And now, you know, now you think that you can take a position on Dhoni and get away, Mr. Soni. You can't.
No, I am not. I am very much for action against Dhoni. But what I am trying to say is that even, and I agree with you, Arnab, even board administrators did not come out openly. When we had these elections this year, nobody from South Zone even nominated a candidate for presidency.
No, I don't care about your cricket politics.
You
the fact is that in India TV, the news channel, ran a sting operation in May 2012, which exposed the rot in the IPL. You know, it wasn't, nobody really woke up and says, you know, the rot runs deep. Everybody said, let's take a little bit of nominal action and hope that no news channel reveals anything anymore. Next caller from Chennai is Shivam. Shivam, good evening. Hi, Arnab here. What's your point?
Arnab.
Good evening, Shivam. Good evening.
I want to put my view.
Yeah. Yeah.
Dhoni and Srinivasan, they should be banned for life. And they both are should be put in the jail for minimum of 3 years for the wrongdoing, for cheating the public. And Srinivasan has to pay also for the losses IPL incurred.
Well, a lot of people are holding Dhoni responsible.
Then only everybody will be get scared. And nobody will try to imagine to do such things.
And what if Dhoni says, Shivam, that I don't care really what you say, what people say, you know, there's nothing legally...
The Supreme Court has to give a verdict like that. Supreme Court should send them to jail because the Pakistan people in the UK, they are sent to jail for 3 years.
Okay, Shivam, thanks very much. You made a point there, not a question. So I'm going to go on to our next caller. Getting a lot of callers on this subject from Baroda. From Baroda, Mr. Ghosh. Yes, Mr. Ghosh, good evening. Arnab here.
Yes, good evening, Mr. Arnab. I'm a staunch follower of cricket and as well as of your news channel.
Thank you.
And first, I salute you for your remarks and for your interpretation of all the subjects. But I want to ask any of the senior panels who are present here, that can anyone say that who is the best man suitable for the president of the post? Because everybody is involved in some kind of way with malefied intention with BCCI.
Well, good point.
They are sitting on such a huge money.
Okay.
They are so senior guys sitting in your panel, sir. Can anyone say, yes, he's the best man who can head the BCCI?
Mr. Ghosh, by the way, stay on the line. Kishore Bimani wants to take that. You know, I'm just sensing, I had not planned to open up the lines on the News Hour today, but you open up the lines because there's so much pressure. Everyone's calling. Everybody in this country is furious. And today the gods of cricket are being asked questions. I'm so happy for it. Mr. Ghosh, stay on the line. Kishorda, respond to him.
Mr. Bimani, I have a great respect
I want to say that very briefly.
No, he's saying something to you, Mr. Bimani. Yes, Mr. Thank Ghosh, you. What are you saying to Mr. Bimani?
I'm saying I have a great respect for Mr.
Very
Bimani.
Briefly.
Let him give the answer. He's a very absolutely impartial man.
Very briefly and very, very sincerely, I'd like to see Shashank Manohar as president. I'd like to see Ajay Shirke as treasurer. And like to see Sanjay Jagdale as the secretary. I mean, there are lovely people in this board. They're honest, hardworking people. And these are the kind of people, if they could get, believe me, I repeat Shashank Manohar, because he is above any kind of corruption.
All right. Now I'm just going to take one more call. And to everyone who's calling tonight, I'm really sorry if I haven't been able to take your calls, but I'm overwhelmed by the number of calls from everywhere. We've gone to Chennai, Bangalore. Next caller, we're going to take the last caller from Gurgaon. And it's Vishal. Vishal, good evening.
Good evening, Arnab.
Good evening.
Arnab, first of all, I'm biggest of your fans. And your debates are my evening food. So thank you very much.
Thank you for watching.
Okay. Now, my question is to these all gentlemen sitting here, and obviously would be to loads of politicians who are the members there, and the ex-cricketers who, you know, have bring laurels to this country. I want to ask them if the system of course, admin of any organization goes wrong or rot, why are not they standing in time on the time when actually it is needed? It is very, very easy to, you know, have your views, but at the time when they know that things are going wrong, why are not they standing up? Is it their country not first for them?
I think that's, Vishal, you know, you've hit the nail on the head, and I'm glad we're asking these questions. Let Saad Bing and then Atul Vasan answer that. Saad, why are all these top cricketers quiet, you know? It's like they all have this ostrich-like attitude. They've buried their head in the sand and pretending that this is not happening.
You know, let's first answer the first question, Arnab, about the politicians.
Yeah, yeah. Of course.
Now the gentleman who's asked is such a fantastic question, this. Listen, you have to know that the BCCI, the amount of rubbish that it's doing, the politician sits there and protects it. So the politician is the inner circle of the coterie for the BCCI. Without the politician, the BCCI will not survive. And that is why the and whenever a politician comes in, there will be political solutions. There'll be a mess. There might be corruption. But definitely all the agencies that are connected with the government will stop working. And therefore, the BCCI uses the politician.
Cozy
as far
circuit.
As the players are concerned, they are not going to say anything. Yeah. Completely confused. Sorry.
No, I just want Atul.
They're compromised.
I just want to let Atul in once. You know, the politicians, the cricketers, the administrators, all in this together, aren't they? All in this one big cozy club that's happened, hopefully being broken up now.
Yeah, really. Yeah, I mean, you know, I'm really amused at, you know, such obvious things being discussed again and again. We all know how unilaterally the board works and why people are not speaking, because they don't want to be kalidas. They don't want to be sitting on the same branch and cut it. Everybody has to fall in line. Why are we so shocked about it? And these people who are involved also must be aghast at the kind of scrutiny and interest is suddenly raised. And I think it's the supreme authority in the country who has to actually take cognizance of fact and say something about it. And I think now the time has come to change the constitution. I've said it again and again. In DDCA, Bishan Singh Bedi lost to a carpenter. He got 4 votes against 500. So unless the system changes, you will keep on having people coming through the ranks, investing years and years in their status stations, getting their crumbs here and there. And anybody who speaks up will be either sidelined or made to join in. I mean, well, please wake up and spell the
You know,
coffee.
People speak up sometimes when the tide is turning. The tide is turning now, everyone's speaking up. The Saad wants to still argue with you. Saad, you call Atul now and continue the argument because I'm short of time. But to all the gentlemen debating this tonight, Mr. Mohan included, I thank you very much for taking part in this debate. Mr. Dhoni, of course, we still have to hear from him. Thank you for joining me on this debate on the News Hour tonight.